Wally's ASMR World and a bonus. It's a bonus video. It's a bonus because I had no plans to do this until about 4 minutes ago. That's the truth. I had a quick shower, made a coffee, and I mentioned on the video, the other video I've uploaded today, about the European football results. I mentioned I planned on watching the Dortmund-Bayern Munich Super Cup final in Germany, because it's on Sky. I figured, why not do a bonus video, like a little play-by-play video. It will be 90 bloody minutes long. Now, but we'll do where, like, I'll do 10-15 minutes per half, and a little bit of half-time, give or take. So, the teams are on the pitch at the minute. I'm waiting to get the team news. These two are in the final because Bayern won the league, Dortmund won the German Cup. This is basically like a German Community Shield, though it's happening after the German League has started, whereas the Premier League happens before the season starts, as we all know. Ignore the hair, I've just stuck, or just blow dried it backwards to keep it out of my face. So we've got Haaland on the TV. There's Thomas Müller holding up a Bayern Munich shirt. I think that's with Gerd Müller's name on. He passed away this week. Legendary striker Gerd Müller, who wore the number 9 for Bayern. Lewandowski's also holding up the shirt. I think all the Bayern players are. Another passing in between them. Müller's got it. Neuer just held up one. Lewandowski had one. Okay. I think it's like just ask the players who they associate with proper Bayern Munich players to do it. I don't want to ask the young lad Musiala to do it. We've got Marco Reus there on the pitch for Dortmund. Jude Bellingham's on the pitch. Axel Witsel. I've not seen the lineups yet. Upamecano is on there for Bayern. I've tipped both teams to score in this game. I should have a bet on this game and a couple of the matches tonight. I'll tell you what they are in a little bit when I get a chance to look. I'm just going to swap hands. Bear with me. So this setup isn't obviously ideal. Oh, they've already kicked off. Let's find out the squad, the team news. Wait there. Hold the back page. We've got Leroy Sané's on the pitch. This really isn't helping, is it? Hang on. Okay, I've just had to wind back the, because I've got Virgin Media, so I was able to pause it, look at TVL. So let me tell you the team news. Dortmund have Kabel in goal, Akanji, Witsel. I can't even see his name because it's so far away. Schultz at left back, Reiner. Oh, Paslak at right back. Dahoud, Bellingham in midfield along with Reiner, the young lad. Then Marco Reus, Haaland, and Moukoko, who's another forward, another young forward, they're playing two up front, with Reus behind. That's the Dortmund team. So look at the Bayern team. Come on, speed up, guys. Bear with us. Here's a go. Manuel Neuer, as I said already, in goal. Nick Sule and Upamecano in the back two. Alphonso Davies, left back, right back, Stanisic. Kimmich is in a sweeper role. Leon Goretzka, Thomas Müller. And then in front of them we've got Gnabry, Coleman and Lewandowski. So no Leroy Sané, my bad. I don't know if they're going to tell us the substitutes or not. I'm not too sure, let's have a look. So I have to wind this forward now. See if they'll tell us the substitute bench. Nope, they've not told us who's on the bench. Okay, I'm going to wind it on now to catch up the game. So I'll tell you all in a bit what's going on. Okay, so in terms of injuries and players missing, Dortmund have Axel Witsel and Akanji in the back two. Hassan Nabri here. Oh, he just played it straight into a Dortmund player. A Dortmund player gave the ball away, went straight to Nabri, but he, rather than pass the ball to Lewandowski, played it back to a Dortmund defender. I think it was Akanji. Bayern, this is like only their second like competitive game without the likes of Jerome Boateng and David Alaba at the club. So Sule and Upamecano are in for them, like I said. On paper, I don't fancy either of these defences holding up against Lewandowski or Haaland. If I'm being honest, good ball there from Coleman to Lewandowski, but Akanji got the ball back and it's cleared by Paslak, the right back. Goretzka with a header and they lose out with Jude Bellingham getting on the ball. Dortmund's new manager, I need to check out who that is. I recognise him but not. I can't tell you who it is for certain. Let's have a look. So far this has been rather poor from Dortmund's defence. I am joking, Akanji has put his teammates under pressure on at least three occasions. Just bad passes. A minute ago he played the ball back and it was meant for, I think it was, Paslak, the right back, played the ball back and rather than it going to Akanji, he went straight to a Bayern player. A chance for Lewandowski, one for Kingsley Coman. Bayern are on the loop break again here. I mean, they haven't got Benjamin Pavard in their team. At right back, he's out injured for Bayern. I'm not sure if Sane's on the bench. Hope Dortmund have a chance. Ball play forward for Haaland. Upamecano gets back and clears the ball there, but goes straight back to a Dortmund player. And they're on the move again. Jude Bellingham. Oh, he's through, he's through. Oh my god. Sorry, what a great chance there for Michael Royce. Like that, I mean, this lad, he's like 17, 18, Jude Bellingham. He played a beautiful ball. Jude Bellingham did there, straight through the middle of Sule and Alphonso Davies. And it reached Michael Royce. But Neuer, what a save. What a save by Manuel Neuer. Came out, stopped with his right foot. How the hell he could stop that, I do not know. He sort of skidded off his right boot. Corner for Dortmund, here we go. Didn't even beat the first man. They're going to whip it in now, though. He's come back out to a Dortmund player, for it's Reina. He's played it to his left-sided attacker. Cleared by Upamecano again. Nabri onto Coleman. Kingsley Coleman back to his right back. And here they go on the break. It's Thomas Muller. What no, is it? I think that might have been Lewandowski, sorry. Yeah, right, Lewandowski tries to cross the ball, but it's blocked by a Dortmund player. But Haaland's had next to no chances. And I'm shocking to hear. Who I do feel has done well and surprised me is their other attacker, Moukoko. He's got backs of pace, similar to Haaland, but not as big or strong, but still very quick on the ball. We've got a Bayern Munich corner now. They're showing Hansi Flick, the former Bayern Munich manager, in the crowd. It's whipped in, headed by Muller, I think it was, who's going out. For some reason, a Dortmund player kept in. The Dortmund manager I found out is Marco Rose. Marco Rose. If we could have an accent. And he's the former Borussia Mönchengladbach manager. He was there last season. He's now at Dortmund. But this Dortmund defence has been horrendous. I mean, Mats Hummels isn't up to much lately. He's getting on a bit. But it'd at least bring a bit of order to this team. I have heard that there's a chance that Emre Can will be playing centre-back a lot for them this season. But he isn't fit, I don't think, today. Got a yellow card for, who's this for? A Bayern player, Nicolas Sule, has just been booked. Goretzka seemed to think if he stood in front of Sule, the ref wouldn't see him. Goretzka forgot that Sule was about 8 foot tall. Yeah, definitely was two-footed on Holland. Not dangerous, but wearing both feet. And he got the yellow card, Sule did. And we have a Dortmund free kick just outside the box. This will be interesting to see what Royce can do with this. Can he pop it in the top corner? So Dortmund have brought in a new keeper this season as well. The one I mentioned at the beginning. He's their new number one. Here we go. Marco Royce standing over the ball. Apparently he's been moved up to like a number 10 position this season. And really like improved his form and injury record. They reckon he's going to improve that because he will be getting booed by fullbacks so much on the wing. And here we go, free kick. Was never troubling Manuel Neuer. Straight over the turnbuckle. Off the turnbuckle. It's not wrestling, it's straight off the crossbar, my bad. I apologise. I'll come back in a bit. Sorry guys, Haaland's just had a great chance. We're in the 38th minute of the game. He's getting a bit frustrated with his teammates. But there's been more than one occasion where he's just brushed Upamecano aside, and Upamecano's a big lad. But Haaland's just pushed him aside like he's not there. Moukoko, I think it's Moukoko. I've literally just found out he's 16 years old. I'm not even joking, guys. This lad is a star in the making. Now they've brought in the lad Marlon from he's from PSV. I might be wrong, or Feyenoord. He's in the Dutch team for the Euros. Great save by Neuer to stop Haaland. And then Haaland was stopped for fouling Alphonso Davies when he tried to win the ball back. Yeah, Moukoko is 16 years old. He scored. He was offside, to be fair, but the strength and composure he showed to finish off the chance, put it past Manuel Neuer, one of the best keepers in the world. At 16 years old, he's literally involved with everything. Quite a bit shorter than Haaland, but obviously like about 7 years younger. And this lad could, buy another friend a quick free kick. Gnabry on the ball, and something just happened there. Dortmund players ain't happy. If one of the defenders slipped in the box, but Dortmund have got right back into this game. As the game's gone on, defence has made less mistakes. With here they go now. Coleman for Bayern Munich crosses the ball. Just as I say, Dortmund have got back into it. A cross from Kingsley Coman, a really good cross. Who is on the end? Robert Lewandowski. Arrived in the box, smashed it forehead on the end of the ball, straight in the back of the net. We don't get on the end of a ball, do you? But Nagelsmann is there, celebrates on the touchline. And it was from a Bayern Munich, from a Dortmund defensive clearance. It's another bad ball. And Bayern Munich intercepted the ball. And great cross. It's actually Gnabry, not Coman, my bad. Serge Gnabry with the cross. And Lewandowski with the finish. Great header. But this is like Moukoko. I think him and Haaland this season could be fantastic for Dortmund at 16 years old. That is mental. Anyways, it's only a couple minutes from half time, so we'll do a catch up at half time, guys. Okay, guys, we've just started the second half. Sané has come on very early on in the second half for Koeman. Coleman, rather not Koeman, my bad. It's not Ronald Koeman, is it? It's Kingsley Coleman. I think it might have been an injury. He didn't go for half time. He went off with like 2 minutes into the second half. And literally, as Coleman's gone off, Bayern have scored a second goal. So, a free kick. is, yep, Alphonso. So one of the, I think it was Zule to the free kick, to Davies, on to Gnabry, back to Davies, or straight to Gnabry, on to Davies, or whatever. And Alphonso Davies crossed the ball. Lewandowski made it like he was going to backheel into the goal. But instead he backheeled it into the path of Muller. And Muller put it away. Literally, you had Lewandowski, Muller, and Sané all beyond the Dortmund defence. Not offside, like they'd be in the offside trap. So any one of the three was going to tap that in. Now, one of these days, I'll give you my conspiracy theory of what I think is going to happen with Haaland. And it's because of games like this that I think it'll happen, because he's not going to do what he should do whilst at Dortmund. It was a very good stepping stone from Salzburg to go to Dortmund. I think this is Reiner that's been taken out by a Bayern Munich player. Let's have a look. I'm sure it's Reiner. Yeah, and Alphonso Davies has come down on his knee with the studs. Nothing malicious. Just Reiner tackled Davies, and Davies couldn't put his feet anywhere else. Complete accident. But I do have a theory about Haaland and what's going to happen at the end of the season, and I'll reveal it in another video in the next week. I'll do a little video on maybe like conspiracy theories or something like that, or my predictions for next season, because this is when I think it'll happen at the end of the season going into next season. Anyways, I'm off to watch some more of this game. We'll catch up in a bit, guys. So, Dortmund have just had a second goal disallowed for offside. Haaland this time. I'm not certain who played the pass. Because one of the commentators is talking with a very strong Austrian accent or German accent. So I didn't know who he said. It wasn't Bellingham. I'm not sure, it might have been Royce. And it was a great ball from a Dortmund player. Through to Haaland. He went on past Upamecano and Sule, put it past Neuer, but he was judged to be offside, rightly so, but disappointing all the same, because they've had two goals now, both chalked off for offside. Okay guys, so we're at the 64th minute mark. The commentary team just said, I don't know, Dortmund are going to get through here. Like they've run out of ideas, the commentary said. The ball is played to Royce, I don't know, outside the box. They were getting past the Bayern defence. The ball's played to Royce from the right hand side. He curls in a beautiful goal. Top right hand corner. Like I said, I had both teams to score on my bet, which that's now happened. Problem is, I also backed Morecambe to win or draw, and they're losing. Home to Rotherham. And I backed Reading to win or draw, and they're currently losing to Bristol City. So at the moment, the bet's off, but we got a game on here. Dortmund are 2-1 down. They brought on Marlon, the Dutch lad, came for Makuku, and he had a chance. For some reason, he completely fluffed his lines. Neuer's knackered his ankle. He tried to clear the ball. Kicked straight against Haaland's leg. And now, Neuer is just taking a minute to get himself sorted. Anyways, let's carry on. We're at 65th minute. Oh, 66th minute now. Okay, guys, we just had Corentin Tolisso come on for Bayern. And Musiala, he came off Thomas Muller. It was 2-1 to Bayern at the time. The ball goes back to the Dortmund keeper. He plays it to Akanji, who goes to play onto Witzel, I think it was. It was blocked by Tolisso, straight into the path of Lewandowski. And Lewandowski put the ball in the back of the net. He was never going to miss it from that distance. It's now 3-1. 2 by Munich, 3-1. Okay, guys, so the game has sort of just died off a bit now since the third goal went in. It's been a bit of pushing and shoving between a Dortmund and Bayern player, who's Tolisso, and I can't remember the Dortmund player, to be honest. Bayern have just brought on Bubizarre, I think that's his name, for their right back, and they brought on Choupo-Moting for Lewandowski. Let's think about that. I'm bringing Eric Maxim Choupo-Moting and taking off Robert Lewandowski. It's quite funny to hear. But yeah, Bayern have got this game won. There's like a minute of normal time to go. The 3-1 up, taking a corner here. Easy save for the Dortmund keeper. So tries to play out field, he slipped on his arse. Let me know, guys, if you've enjoyed this video and would like more of these play-by-play videos in the future. Long-time viewers will know I used to go live during big Champions League games. I'm not sure we'll do that again. We'll definitely do some more of these, I think. Yeah, I feel sorry for people like Haaland and Bellingham, and even the new lad Moukoko, because they all put in a great shift. Akanji just seemed to be desperate to make the Bayern hierarchy happy by presenting the ball to them every chance he had. Also Marco Reus for his goal, and just a very good performance as well. We're at Sané goes last minute of normal time, 89 minutes and 50 seconds, and he's lost the ball, which is just typical Leroy Sané, isn't it? Definitely flies to impress. Should have been 4-1 by then. Tolisso, the Dortmund defence, lost the ball again. It's played onto Tolisso. He tries to turn and shoot on the spot, and it's taken off his feet by a Dortmund player. Upamecano then gives it away to, I think it's Reus, I might be wrong. And Haaland's just getting a bit fed up now, you can tell. Hey guys, okay, so the game ended 3-1 in the end to Bayern Munich. Basically the team with the stronger attacking threat, like all throughout, came out on top. Defensively, both teams are bang average. Maybe Bayern was slightly better defensively. Obviously, they got a better goalkeeper. Upamecano on his day is better than the Dortmund defence. So that's always going to be an advantage. Plus, got Alphonso Davies in there. And Kimmich in midfield. And attacking wise, the better players. The bench is really poor. Dortmund, I feel sorry for Haaland, like I said, and a few of the other players. There was a chance for Haaland late on, last minute or two, but yeah, I think it was saved by